My name's Dave Wilhelm. I'm a professor at Wake Technical Community College in Raleigh, North Carolina. I have a number of videos on my YouTube channel, Dave Wilhelm NC, all one word, no spaces. Mostly I do this for my online classes and a bit for my seated classes. In this case, though, I'm simply fascinated by Giffen goods. I got curious when I went to look at the explanations on YouTube and other places. There were phrases like incremental propensity to consume, and I got lost. And all I really wanted was a couple simple examples. And that's what I did. A Giffen good, and some economists would say, it's not so much the good itself as the situation that a person who's consuming a Giffen good finds themselves in. So definition, a Giffen good is an inferior good whose price increase results in an increase in the quantity demanded due to necessity and limited income. In economist speak, the income effect is greater than the substitution effect. I thought about that. I think I understand it, but not well enough to explain it. We'll look at two situations, a stable, quiescent situation that's been going along. Everything's fine. And then the inferior good price increases, and we'll see the impact of that. And the impact is that when the inferior good price increases, our demand for that inferior good goes up. And because it does require a certain situation, that's why some economists call it a behavior, different behavior, rather than different good. I actually have another video on YouTube called Giffen Goods, which is a bit more comprehensive. It has a number of different examples. This is short and sweet. We're just going to look at one example. Well, quiescent and then a change. So our scenario is that a person needs 1,700 calories per day. Their income is $27 per day, and their only expense is food. Yes, we're oversimplifying, but we have to. There are two sources for the food. A preferred normal good at $2 per 100 calories, and a satisfactory, but not really desirable, inferior good at $1 per 100 calories. So maybe we think steak and hamburger, or lobster and fish or something. So for $1, you can buy 50 normal calories or 100 inferior calories. The people greatly prefer the normal good, but if they have to, they will eat the inferior good. So our constraints are 1,700 calories per day, $27 per day, and when there's a choice, we prefer the normal good over the inferior good. So the quiescent point, let's see if we can find that, what the situation is right now. If we just get the normal goods, we need that 1,700 calories and $2 per 100 calories, and that will cost us $34, and that does not work because we've overspent. If we try all the inferior good, 1,700 calories times $1 per 100 calories, that's $17. That doesn't work because there is money left over that could be spent on more normal good, so that's also no go. Where we find the optimal point, of course, is increasing the amount of inferior good, decreasing the amount of normal good until we find an optimum point, and that turns out to be spend $20 on normal goods for 1,000 calories, $7 on inferior goods for 700 calories. Our total, we have spent exactly $27, and we've achieved our 1,700 calories. If we try to get more normal good and less inferior good, we're going to exceed the budget. If we eat more inferior good, then we would be eating too little normal good and having some money left over, and that would violate our initial constraints. Okay, the inferior good price increases. Now what? This is the same scenario as the initial quiescent point. What we're going to change is that the inferior good is now $150 per $1.50 per 100 calories rather than $1 per 100 calories. And that means that for $1 we can get 67 inferior calories. Otherwise, it's all the same. So the price of the inferior good has risen. And what happens now? Well, this was our original quiescent point, $20, 1,000 calories for normal, $7, 700 calories from the inferior good. So we have the $27 and the 1,700 calories. If we continue to spend the same amount on each, we'll still have our $27, but because the inferior good price has gone up, we're only getting 467 calories out of the inferior good, so we don't have enough calories. We're within budget, but not enough calories. The actual optimum point, so what we're going to have to do is we're going to need to stay within the $27, increase the calories, and the only way to do that is to increase the amount of the inferior good we buy. Price of the inferior good went up. To maintain our $27 budget and our 1,700 calorie requirement, we're going to have to increase the amount of the inferior good whose price just increased. And the new optimum point, $6 and 300 calories on the normal good, $21 and 1,400 calories from the inferior good. So there's our $27 and here's our 1,700 calories. The only way to meet the calorie requirements and stay within the budget is to increase the inferior good consumption, even though its price has increased. And you can play around with this, but we're pretty much stuck with it. Anything we do is either going to increase the price or decrease the calories. So that's my Giffen Good example. If you want a bunch more information, look at the Giffen Goods presentation. Otherwise, I hope this has given you a decent Giffen Good example. Perhaps it's excited your curiosity about Giffen Goods, and you'll go out and do some investigation yourself.